गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज आस मोहम्मद खान एंड आई वेलकम यू इन टुडे सेगमेंट। स्टूडेंट्स, इन आवर प्रीवियस सेगमेंट वी हैव डिस्कस अबाउट द फिजिकल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ द मैटर। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द केमिकल प्रॉपर्टीज। नाउ हाउ डू वी नो अबाउट द केमिकल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ द सब्सटेंस? वी नो अबाउट द केमिकल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ द सब्सटेंस विद द हेल्प ऑफ केमिकल रिएक्शंस। So metal and non-metals both perform the chemical reactions, and with the help of those chemical reactions we can know about their chemical nature. And what is the basic chemical property that they have? Today we will discuss about it. All the metal students, they are electropositive in nature, means they are electropositive. Now, who are positive student? Who are positive? Can you tell me? In general language, we use this word positive, be positive, try to be positive. What is the meaning of positivity? Or what is the meaning of positive? Means the person who always be ready to help other, to give something. So like those person, metals always ready to help other substances to give their electron. And how do they give the electrons? They give the electrons by losing, means they lose their electron. That's why they are known as electropositive. So metals are electropositive in nature because they can lose their electron, and it is their basic chemical property from which they perform the different chemical reactions. Like this, non-metals are electronegative in nature, means they are always ready to accept something from other, means they accept the electron or they gain the electron from other metal or non-metals. That's why they are electronegative in nature. So in the chemical property you will learn it, and this topic again you will read in the 9th class and 10th class, that the metals are electropositive in nature and non-metals are electronegative in nature. Metals are always ready to lose their electron, and non-metals are always ready to gain their electron or to accept the electron. So it is about the metal and non-metal basic chemical property. Now with the help of this property student, what they do? Metal and non-metal react with each other. And what they form? They form ionic compound. What they form? They form ionic compound. Like there is one metal student, and what is it? And it is the most reactive metal, means it reacts vigorously, very fastly. And what is the name of that metal? It is sodium. What is it? It is sodium. So sodium is the metal. This is the sodium. And sodium can lose its electron and it become electropositive. Electropositive it becomes, and by losing one electron, because it has one electron extra in its outermost shell. Like this, there is one non-metal and it is chlorine. And it accepts one electron from other metal like sodium, and it becomes electronegative. Why, student? Because it has one less electron in its outermost shell. So with the help of this electropositivity and electronegativity, they react with each other. Like the Na plus plus Cl minus, and they react with each other and they form NaCl. NaCl. Now, when the matter, like this is the matter and it is electropositive and this is non-matter, when matter and non-matter react with each other, then they form the compound, and that compound is known as ionic compound. This is ionic compound. Means when the matter and non-matter react with each other, then they form ionic compound, this type of ionic compound. And this ionic compound we use in our daily life. NaCl, sodium chloride, and it is known as the cooking salt. The cooking items that we prepare, then in those cooking items in general, what we add the salt, and that salt is sodium chloride. That's why it is also known as table salt. Table salt, because it is generally found on the dining table. That's why it is known as table salt. And this table salt is made up of ionic, is known as ionic compound, and it is made up of metal and non-metal. Means when metal and non-metal react with each other, then they form ionic compound. So this is the basic chemical property of metal and non-metal. Now we come on the other chemical property, and it is given in your book, like the reaction of metal with oxygen. Reaction of metal with oxygen, student. So students, metal and non-metal react with oxygen, and when they react with oxygen, then metal forms metallic oxide and non-metal forms non-metallic oxide. So this you will learn. So metal react with oxygen, then what they form? They form metallic oxide. And when non-metal react with oxygen, then what they form? They form non-metallic oxide. Non-metallic oxide. So these reactions takes place when the metal and non-metal react with the oxygen. Now we will do the example. Like there is one metal, student, that is magnesium. When the magnesium react with the oxygen, then what it forms? It forms magnesium oxide, MgO. Like this, when the iron react with the oxygen, then it forms iron oxide. When the calcium react with the oxygen, then it forms calcium oxide. Like this, there is one non-metal, student, that we use in our daily life. It is carbon. When the pure form of the carbon react with the oxygen, then it forms carbon dioxide. So when the non-metal react with the oxygen, then they form the non-metallic oxide, and when the metal react with the oxygen, then they form metallic oxide. Now these oxides have the different chemical nature, like magnesium oxide. Magnesium oxide is basic in nature, means when it is reacted with water, then it forms magnesium hydroxide. And magnesium hydroxide is basic in nature. And when we dip the litmus paper in that, then that litmus paper will be changed from red to blue due to this basic nature. Like this, this non-metallic oxide, carbon dioxide, is acidic in nature. When this carbon dioxide is reacted with water, then it forms carbonic acid. Like this, when the sulfur is reacted with oxygen, then it forms the sulfur dioxide. And when that sulfur dioxide is reacted with water, then it forms the sulfurous acid or sulfuric acid. And that nature we can also know with the help of litmus paper, in which ब्लू लिटमस पेपर इज चेंज इनटू रेड बिकॉज इट फॉर्म्स विच टाइप ऑफ ऑक्साइड इट फॉर्म्स एसिडिक ऑक्साइड बट मेटल फॉर्म्स बेसिक ऑक्साइड इन जनरल दे फॉर्म बेसिक ऑक्साइड बट देर आर सम मेटल स्टूडेंट लाइक एल्यूमिनियम दे फॉर्म बोथ टाइप ऑफ मेटेलिक ऑक्साइड एसिडिक एज वेल एज बेसिक डैट्स वाई दीज मेटेलिक ऑक्साइड्स आर नोन एज एम्फोटेरिक ऑक्साइड एंड इट इज द मोस्ट इम्पोर्टेंट क्वेश्चन स्टूडेंट एंड इट इज जनरली आस्क्ड इन द कम्पिटिटिव एग्जाम डेट विच इज द एम्फोटेरिक ऑक्साइड सो एम्फोटेरिक ऑक्साइड आर द मेटेलिक ऑक्साइड डैट शोज द बोथ टाइप ऑफ नेचर एसिडिक एज वेल एज बेसिक नेचर सो इट इज अबाउट द एम्फोटेरिक ऑक्साइड नाउ यू लर्न मेटल फॉर्म्स द मेटेलिक ऑक्साइड नॉन मेटल फॉर्म द नॉन मेटेलिक ऑक्साइड सो इन द नेक्स्ट वीडियो वी विल डिस्कस द अदर केमिकल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ मेटल एंड नॉन मेटल थैंक यू वेरी मच एंड हैव ए प्लेजेंट डे